In this video, I will provide an overview of how to make a decision on a manuscript in Editorial Manager. As an editor, you can make a decision on a manuscript at any time. Usually, this happens after receiving peer reviews or determining the manuscript suitability. I will now show you how to make a decision once you have the reviewer's recommendations and comments. Once all required reviews are submitted, the manuscript will appear in the Submissions with Required Reviews Complete folder on your editor main menu, and you'll receive a notification. To make your decision, go to this folder, find the manuscript, and click Submit Editor's Decision and Comments in the Action column. You're now on the editor decision form, which may vary by journal and role. If you see the Terminate Outstanding Assignments and Proceed button at the top and bottom of this page, it means there are still pending reports from reviewers or recommendations from subordinate editors. You need to terminate the pending items or wait for them to be submitted before you can finalize your decision. If you don't have permission to terminate these assignments, you can only enter comments and save your progress, but you won't be able to complete or submit your decision until the other tasks are finished. View reviewer and subordinate editor comments by clicking on their recommendation terms in the table. Click on the recommendation term to open the full review in a new window. Here you'll find the reviewer's recommendation, answers to custom questions, comments to author, confidential comments to editor, and any attachments. Download the original or sanitized version to decide if it should be shared with the author. The Reopen Review button allows you to send a review back to the reviewer so that they may add additional information. Note that you cannot reopen the review if the editor has already started and saved a decision. To save any changes, click Save and Close. If you want to exit without saving, click Cancel. Follow these steps for other recommendations also. Click the Attachments link. Any attachments submitted relating to this manuscript are shown below. You can click Upload Attachments to upload your own attachment as an editor if you wish. Checking the box Allow Author Access will make the file visible to the author when they revise the submission or views the editor decision. Note that reviewers always have access to their own comments, but need permission to view other reviewers' comments to author. To enable this, check Allow Reviewer Access. Once you are ready to make your decision, choose the appropriate decision term from the drop-down menu. These terms are defined per journal. In the Confidential Comments to the Editor section, you can provide comments directly to the main editor that will not be shared with the author. If you are a subordinate editor without the permissions to notify the author of the decision, use this section to include any confidential notes, such as the justification for your recommendation, that you wish to convey to the higher-level editor. Enter your comments for the author in the Comments to Author section. This section may already include comments from subordinate editors. Any text you add here will be automatically included in the decision letter. In the Individual Reviewer Comments to Author section, you can view each reviewer's comments to the author and edit or exclude specific comments from the decision letter if necessary. The Production Notes section lets you add any notes for the production department regarding an accepted submission. In the Reviewer Questions and Responses section, you can view the review questions and the reviewer's responses. Editor decision phrases are predefined phrases used by journals to ensure consistency and save time in decision letters. Editors can quickly insert these phrases into letters instead of typing them out. Select the relevant phrases for the decision letter. If you would like to add additional phrases here, contact your journal manager. Note that phrases selected by subordinate editors will appear as checked boxes on the upper level editor's page. Respond to the questions in the Editor Review Questions section and then click Proceed. In the Draft Decision page, you can preview the decision and comments. Click Edit Decision to make changes. If you lack permission to draft the letter, use the Submit Decision button to finalize and pass the submission to the higher-level editor to notify the author. Click Proceed to submit your decision and continue to draft the decision letter. The Notify Author page lets you inform the author of the decision. The revision due date and decision term are pre-filled but can be modified. You may also copy or blind copy assigned editors or add other email addresses. Review the letter carefully, as editor comments, individual reviewer comments, and decision phrases have been automatically inserted. You can make any changes to the letter if required. To notify the author, click Send Now. You may be asked if you want to notify reviewers. Click Send All Letters to inform them of your decision. You will then see a final confirmation detailing which letters were sent to which recipients. This is the process for making a decision as an editor and editorial manager. Please visit the Journal Article Publishing Support Center should you require further information. Thank you for watching.